Sports Tonight on channels, television, we're taking a look at a corporate sponsorship for sports because we need the support of the private sector, which is saying that government cannot do it alone. And that's what is happening to Joy Udo-Gabriel. Remember that female track and field, that track athlete station that went to the Commonwealth Games, and then she did that bit, yeah, 900 meters, gave us the personal best, and then went on to win bronze in the 4x100 meters relay. Let's listen to Joy and her sports. So then I will come back to put more perspectives on the need for private sector to support sports in the country.
When I did 11.8 seconds, that's the sub-12, when I literally did 11 at the Golden League in Korea, I did 11.8. I was like, wow, so if I can do 11, I can go faster and all. And so that was the time I knew that I could do better than what I was doing then. It felt very awesome, like, you know, I couldn't cry then, but it's not very great because, you know, I hear about these people. I never even thought I would be at the Commonwealth Games. That wasn't the idea to be. I wasn't, although my coach said, just go there, try your best, you know, you never can tell, you can make the team. And eventually I did. And even when I got to the Commonwealth Games, I was so excited. You know, even when I wanted to run, the crowd, I didn't realize there was so much crowd until I finished running.
That's a sweet, good experience in the back. So much crowd, but she was intense. Yeah. Instead, she was excited. Rush of blood to the brain, if I saw that, but it worked good for her. She made it to the semis. Round it, actually the best in the world at just 18.
Austin, this is mad. This is fantastic. Yeah. For her to be able to do such thing at her age, I'm just looking at her. So this is not just 18 years old, you know, at heart, you could see that this is somebody that was probably left secondary school some few years ago, you know, if you know recently. And we need to really spend more time in getting this, you know, talent from school competition, ensuring that we revitalize our school competition so that we can have more of this talent at junior level. Yeah. Because if they don't show up at junior level, there is no way they are going to show up at the senior level.
Right.
So we need to really invest a lot in terms of energy, in terms of expertise, in terms of coaching, in terms of scouting, in our getting them at the young level. There's a Nigerian now in Texas.
Okay, tell me about
Divine. What to do? You got 10.10 seconds.
Breaking records.
Yeah. These are the areas that the AFL should be
asking. Something is wrong
with our system here. You know, that was why I was very, very upset when we had that issue, you know, at AFL level about who is going to be the technical director. Because we would, our athlete is already down. The last thing we need is a disunited board. Because there's a lot of talent out there that we are not harnessing. And that's why athletics is suffering seriously. 100, 200 meters that we used to dominate at African level, at Commonwealth level, they are no longer there.
Yeah.
Even Blessing couldn't summon the courage to run 100 or 200 meters. She had to step in for relay. Yeah. You know, so we are still talking of Blessing, look at Barry, still at that level. So we need to reduce the pressure. I know corporate bodies is a fantastic move that they are coming in to assist.
Yeah.
But also, it's important that we point the direction by ensuring that we have structures that make us develop, you know, generate some of these athletes that we can, you know, give to them the
sponsors. I agree. We ask for those corporate bodies to come in and feel relaxed. There must be a responsible leadership in place, a credible leadership in place. There must be accountability. I mean, nobody can put their money into what they're not sure of.
There must be a vision.
We can see. We can see that there's been progress. Joy told us about her progress from her career and then going for more competitions, and now she's gone to the Commonwealth Games. How did it happen? ACO Group, led by the chairman, Mr. Alfred Okoyegun, they supported her alongside making of champions. Let's listen to them, and I'll come back. We'll talk some more.
You see, we are not developed in our country today because we believe so much in expatriates. They will make it. They cannot make it for you. We who must do it. And if the more we use our facilities, the better as well. So that is why, really, we need to now check with our institutions. Look, what can we do to combine this together? So if the institutional syllabus has been such a way that, look, it's just academic, find out what they have done in the U.S. Find out what they have done in other parts of the world, so you can blend it. There are some special education you give to athletes and sports people.
There are many athletes who were ahead of Joy a year ago, 2 years ago, that have gone to America, and they're getting a good education in America. But right now, those athletes are behind Joy, and she's the one who has brought glory to the nation because she's here, not because she's in America. So I just want to be very clear that I'm not against athletes going to America, but we must look at every person's individual situation and say, is it better for them to be here, or is it better for them to be there? And what I will say is that so long as an athlete is getting the right support, the right training, everything they need in Nigeria, a sponsor, then the only time they need to go abroad is to go and compete, represent the country, go to Diamond League eventually, and be internationally mobile but based in Nigeria. And you'll see that to do what Joy has done here will cost probably five times as much to do it in America.
We should talk about it, the need to be resourceful, and that's where the leadership of the Athletics Federation of Nigeria comes in. Now we are identifying people that want to support, that want to come in. We need to draw programs.
Programs, structures, levels, infrastructure.
Mr. Alfred Okoye was very clear. He said we rely so much on foreign things. Meanwhile, the talents are right here.
Because talent is there. Mm-hmm. And nothing in terms of effort is being done to really tap those resources. Mm-hmm. That is why you look at the line of production, really. It's almost as if inefficiency in the structure and the absence of it has sort of stagnated the growth of Nigerian athletics. Who knows if we've had structures over the years that is functional? Maybe we are generating these athletes from high school down to university level, ensuring that they get necessary placement. As he said, you have to look at individual athletes, those that need to go out. Those that will need the system, we try and develop a training structure that will enable them to grow as they progress in age. But when you don't have those kind of structures, and the way it is now, technology has simplified everything. So you can actually copy what is done abroad here and bring it here and customize it to suit the demands of what we have here, and it will work. But unfortunately, over in continuity in policy, this one will come, I want to do my own structure, this one will come in.
And he wants his man.
All those kind of infighting, especially just concentration, but the ability to even get the right ideas on the table. Because if you don't put me as technical director, if I so desire, if I have the wisdom that will make you progress, I will withhold it. Because we don't have a chairman who would come in and ensure that he's the father, so that everybody can bring bright ideas to the table.
No vision.
And can implement it.
No vision. They're not planning.
They're not infighting.
That's right. And when you fail to plan, you plan it to fail.
Absolutely.
We just want to encourage more private sponsorship for sports in Nigeria. So we appreciate our group and what they're doing for Joy and other athletes. Of course, making of champions. Also, we appreciate them because these are the little things that will motivate athletes to do more. They must be comfortable. I mean, that's what it used to be back in the day. Let's not start calling names. Let's just hope for the future.